Hello, someone on YouTube suggested that I may be autistic, and the reasons given were because of my alleged monotone voice and my alleged fixation on exposing old calendarist clergy. This is my response to that accusation. First, let me say here that it does kind of seem like I have developed a monotone voice. I noticed over the last several years that it does seem kind of monotone, but this isn't because of autism. I think it's because of the Orthodox teaching that we're not to show emotional expression. This is the teaching I received, that emotional expression is sinful, and apparently, according to some Orthodox Christians, it's even a sin to yawn. And that's why they cross their mouth when they yawn, as if you're doing something immoral or sinful, which is ridiculous superstition. So Orthodoxy teaches that we should try not to show emotional expression. Even Elder Ephraim said that when we look at things, we damage our nous, which implies that even having our eyes open is some kind of sin. So we might as well just walk around with our eyes closed. You see, everything we do is a sin. According to these teachings, I believe one saint even said that if we laugh, we should try to keep our mouth closed. The implication to these teachings is that you're being a bad Christian if you open your eyes, if you yawn, if you laugh, or if you have any kind of emotional expression. Now, you may say, that's wrong. You didn't receive the teaching correctly. We don't believe those things. Nevertheless, this is the teaching I received, and the only reason why you would reject what I'm saying right now is because you have no respect for me as a person. This is the teaching I received, whether you like it or not. Okay, whether it was correctly transmitted to me or incorrectly, I don't know, but this is the teaching I received. Okay, so let me proceed here. And I want to ask the person this question. Why does it have to be autism? Why can't it be something else? Maybe I expose old Calvinist clergy because I have a love for the truth. And, you know, I have a love for what is right. Maybe I'm not lukewarm. Maybe I don't want to follow nominal status quo Orthodox indifference. Maybe I want to be different. You're not my standard for spiritual life, see? So why does it have to be autism? Why can't it be something else? Can you point me to the literature showing that symptoms of autism include, one, monotone voice, and two, a fixation on something? Point me to the literature. Or did you just invent this out of your own head? I also want to stress here that I've never been diagnosed with autism by any psychiatrist or psychologist with a PhD in psychology or psychiatry. No psychologist or psychiatrist in a professional capacity has ever diagnosed me with this illness. So let me encourage you to cultivate in your soul critical thinking. If someone approaches you and says that they have a degree in psychology or psychiatry, ask them this question. Do you have a PhD in psychology and or psychiatry? And have you ever sat down with him for an hour in a professional capacity in order to get a proper medical diagnosis? That's very important. Ask that person this question. Have you, with a PhD in psychology or psychiatry, ever sat down with him for an hour to get a diagnosis and ask him, are you licensed, or were you licensed when this happened? And also ask him, where the case file is. See, they're not going to be able to do this because it never happened, people. It never happened. Don't let them off the hook. It's very important that you ask those questions. See, make sure they're able to answer all of them. Show me the case file. Were you licensed at the time you sat down with him for an hour? Did you sit down with him for an hour at least? And you have a PhD in psychology or psychiatry, and they're not going to be able to. It's an absolute slanderous lie. Just because some Orthodox Christian with a soft voice may say, oh, I think he has autism, and maybe that person has a BA in psychology, that doesn't prove anything. That doesn't prove anything. You need to have critical thinking developed. Many years ago, critical thinking was removed from the education system. There was actually, I believe, an agenda to do this. See, people are not asking right questions. So if you uncritically accept this slanderous accusation against me, I would say it's because you lack critical thinking skills. And why did you automatically assume that whoever told you this was telling you the truth? Why didn't you check with me to hear my side of the story? It's because you have no respect for me. See, so you lack critical thinking skills, I think. And I would encourage you to take a course in logic or read an introductory textbook on logic. Below in the description box, I'll recommend some books on logic. Logic is an aspect of general revelation about God. It reveals something about God. It's not bad. See, and Constantine Cavarnos, that, you know, Orthodox philosopher, once told me on the phone, I talked to him, that critical thinking was removed. He's one of the sources that told me this. Critical thinking was removed from the education system. There are other sources as well. There's an agenda called Global 2000, also known as America 2000, allegedly, which is actually an agenda to remove critical thinking from the education system. That's why people today are so dumbed down and why they believe things so quickly. That's why people today are so quick to believe New Age lies and fall for cults. Why people hand Walmart greeters their receipts without asking any questions. They're like deer caught in headlights. You know, show me your receipt. And they look at them like deer in headlights. Okay. They don't, you know, someone in a uniform tells them what to do and they comply without asking any kind of questions. This is the mentality of modern man. And it's deplorable. Our education system is a disaster. Take a course in logic. Develop within your soul a love for critical thinking. So basically, that's my challenge to you. And basically, you know, this is just character assassination. And an ad hominem. And the ad hominem fallacy is when you think you've refuted the argument by attacking the man. That is a fallacy. A person could be a totally insane nut job, but still be telling the truth. You need to look at the evidence, engage the evidence. See? And the fact that people out there may be so quick to believe this slanderous lie that I may be autism just betrays the fact they have no critical thinking ability. And when you settle for labels like autism, it shows you're not willing to think. I want to add something here real quick. I have found that monastics have kind of a monotone voice. See? So maybe you haven't been around many monastics. And I also want to say here that this is a recent phenomenon in me. I didn't used to always be like this. So in order, you know, for you to successfully prove your case, you're going to need to be able to prove that I've always had a monotone voice. And you can't do that because I haven't. And you're going to also have to prove that the medical literature shows that a monotone voice is a sign of autism, and you're going to have to be able to give the name of a doctor with a PhD in psychology or psychiatry, who has sat down with me for no less than an hour in a professional capacity, licensed at the time, and direct me to the case file. So you have a heavy burden of proof, and you're not going to be able to prove this. This is all slander. Don't fall for slanderous ad hominems like this, people.